Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. Today we are going to see the most common questions in which every interview will be asking, okay? So first common question is, tell me about yourself. The reason behind HR asking this question is to make the candidate comfortable. He'll be asking this question, okay? Because whenever somebody asks to tell about ourselves, we will feel comfortable because we know everything about ourselves. That's why, okay? So what you need to do is discuss only about you while answering for this question, okay? Just tell about your name, about your personal details, about your educational background. Educational background means you need not tell each and everything. Just tell what is your recent education and where did you complete that. For example, I have completed my MBA from IIM or from IBS, something like that. Okay, just tell your recent qualification along with the place or along with the college name where you have done that. Okay, and also tell about your hobbies. Okay, hobbies means, coming to hobbies, the important thing is that you have to mention the hobby which is useful to the company. For example, if I say my hobby is singing and dancing, what will the company do with your singing and dancing? There is no use with that hobby. Okay, for example, if I tell my hobby is reading books and exploring, learning new things, something like that, it tells that my hobby clearly tells that I am a frequent learner. Okay, so the company will be really having an advantage with my hobbies. Okay, so tell the hobbies which the company impresses with. Okay, and coming to strengths and weakness. Strengths means you can say many examples for strengths. You're a hard worker, you're a quick learner, you're very patient, and you're something like that. Okay, strengths, one or two strengths is good. Okay, and coming to weakness, never tell the weakness which will affect your job. Okay, for example, I lose interest so soon. That is one of the weakness. But if you tell that weakness to HR, you may even lose your interest in the job very quickly, or you may lose interest in the given task very quickly. So why will he hire you? So tell the weakness which will look like weakness, but it is not actually affecting the company. For example, I will tell you an example for the weakness, which is weakness but it is a strength for the company. That is, what shall I say? Yeah, for weakness, I'm telling I will not give up anything so quickly. This is my weakness. Okay, so this is your weakness. You will not give up anything so quickly is your weakness. But coming to the company, when the company has an employee which who will not give up so easily, it is an added advantage to the company. So your weakness is turning into an advantage or strength to the company. So these kind of things you need to select, and easily then you can easily impress the HR. Okay, and don't discuss about your parents and parents' background, all that, in your tell me about yourself question. Okay, the question itself tells, just tell me about yourself. Okay, so discuss only about yourself. Okay, coming to next question, how are you overcoming your weakness? Okay, I already told you this weakness is an advantage for the company. So for this this particular weakness, they'll not ask how are you going to overcome your weakness. But if a few people who tells like I'm afraid of darkness, okay, if I tell such kind of weaknesses, then surely HR will ask how are you overcoming your weakness. Then tell what all things you did to overcome that particular weakness. Okay, next question is, why you want to work with our company? for this particular question, HR is asking just to know your knowledge about that particular company. Like, are you really passionate to work with that company, or randomly you came for that interview? Okay, so what you need to do is just before entering into the company, a night before, like for example, if tomorrow is my interview, today what I need to do is I need to research about the company which I'm going to attend, okay, about the company CEOs, when, in which year the company was established, and where is the head office located of that particular company, and who are the chairpersons of the company, and achievements of the company, and what are the recent innovations of the company, what are the services, products of the company. Just 4 to 5 points about the company which is very important. You need to study and remember that, and whenever the HR asks you about the company, you need to tell all that details so that he will know that you are really passionate about working with that company. Okay, so next question is, why should we hire you? Okay, so for a particular job, there will be some thousands and lakhs of people applying for that particular role. So you have to impress the HR by giving unique answer which is really impressive. For example, he is asking you, why should we hire you? Okay, so you're not the only employee, there are like thousands of people competing with you. So what you need to answer is, you have to tell them all about your skills and all about your knowledge which is related to the job role and which impresses the HR. For example, if I'm looking for the database position post, then what I need to do is I have to tell if I have done any particular certifications for the role of DBA, then I can mention that, and if I have any additional skills which I have for that role, I can mention that. All those stuff I need to do in order to prove that I am the correct person for that particular role. Okay, so next question is, where do you want to see yourself in the near future, or where do you want to see yourself after 5 years? Why the HR is asking this question is, he wants to see, are you really looking forward to work with the company, or you are just having a short-term commitment, means you just want to work till you get your passionate job, and once you get the job you want to run out of the company. Are you like that, or are you really passionate to work with the company for long-term commitment? Because no employer will recruit the person who will just try to skip out of the company whenever he gets the better opportunity. So he is asking you this question. For this, what you need to do is, you have to mention him you wanted to see yourself as a responsible senior officer or responsible senior employee who guides the other employers in the right path, or who helps them out to sort the things out, or something like that. Not like you should never say, I wanted to start a business and I want to become the CEO of the company. These kind of answers you should never give. Okay, you have to tell that I wanted to see myself as a responsible employee in 5 years, and I see myself in the respectable position where I grab knowledge every day and everywhere, like that. Okay, and next question is, what are your salary expectations? Okay, the employer is asking this question in order to know that, are you there only for money, or are you there for passion? Okay, so what you need to do is, I hope the company pays me the best salary as per my knowledge, like the salary which is been paid by the company should be equal to my skills and knowledge. So I hope so this condition satisfies. Okay, in such a way, diplomatic answers you should be giving. Okay, and next question is, Can you work under pressure? For this question, if you say I cannot work under pressure, then the employer thinks whether to hire you or not hire you, because in companies the pressure is the common thing. Okay, there will be sudden deadlines, there will be like, you know, new task every day, so you can't tell that no, I can't work under pressure, I should have the always I should have the limited pressure, all that stuff you are not going to say, and you should never say also. So just tell them, yes, I can work under pressure. In fact, working under pressure will boost my willpower and brings out the best performance from me. Okay, I can work very well even under pressure. Okay, just make sure you tell the HR that you can really work well under pressure. Okay, next question is, will you work extra hours or will you work on weekends? Okay, so as a new employee, it's always good to say that you're ready for working extra hours to impress the HR. So what you need to do is, if there is really the genuine reason which is related to the company will goodwill or company's reputation, I am always ready to work extra hours. Okay, so next question, are you willing to relocate? What you need to answer for this question is, this is completely personal choice. If you are willing to relocate, say yes, I am willing to relocate. Otherwise, no, I am not willing to relocate. Okay, so that's it for today. These are the most common questions where each and every interviewer will ask their candidate during the interview. So that's it for today. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon for more such videos and notifications, like and share this video with all your friends. All the very best for your interview. Just be confident, be patient, and make sure you maintain the correct body language, and just be confident. Always have a smile on your face. So all the best for your interview. Thank you. Thanks for watching.